This is an image of a stapes, the smallest bone in the human body, produced by existing advanced CT technology. This is an image of the same stapes produced by photon-counting CT with no change in radiation dose. Before we show you how such a quantum leap in clarity and precision is now possible, let's quickly review how CT scanners work. The two main components of every CT scanner are the X-ray tube and the detector. As the X-ray tube rotates around the patient at speeds up to 4 rotations every second, it acquires around 1,000 projections per rotation, meaning an individual projection takes 250,000 nanoseconds. Within that one projection, approximately 30,000 X-ray photons arrive at a single detector element, meaning there's only 8 nanoseconds to collect and measure the intensity of each photon before the next impact. Today, even the fastest detectors can't keep up. So traditionally, we end up measuring all 30,000 photons together. Every commercially available CT detector is based on the two-step principle of X-ray scintillation, known commonly as energy integrating detectors. When specific ceramic materials are exposed to X-rays, they generate a light impulse. The light intensity is first measured by a photodiode. It's then converted into an electrical signal we process to create a CT image. This two-step process has some inherent limitations. Since the initial step generates light, we must design portions of the detector to control that light rather than generate signal. These dead spaces lead to inefficiencies that result in higher doses of radiation being required. But if you could measure X-ray impacts without needing to convert them to light first, you could eliminate these dead spaces and improve overall detector efficiency. That's a key difference with photon-counting CT. Its detector uses a crystal semiconductor instead of a ceramic scintillator that directly generates an electric charge rather than creating light first. This direct conversion from X-ray photon to electric signal enables increased measurement speed, a few nanoseconds versus 10,000 or more for a conventional detector. The result? Each of the 30,000 X-ray photons within a single projection can be measured individually. When integrated into CT design, this provides an energy-selective counter-signal of individual pulses, known commonly as photon counting.